Hey there, everyone. Welcome to this week's astrology report for May 16 through May 22nd of 2023. This week in astrology, we have a lot of big changes happening up in the sky, including planets changing signs in rare ways. I'll be talking about that. We have rare alignments happening. We have a Taurus new moon coming up, and also a change of season, a change of focus. So overall, there's going to be a lot of, I think, noticeable changes happening for a lot of people this week, and just the overall vibes will be changing in major ways. So let me start off, like I usually do, by listing all the major aspects for the week, and then we're going to go through the chart day by day and see how it all plays out. So the big thing happening today, actually on Tuesday, is Jupiter ingressing Taurus. That only happens every 12 years, and I will be talking about that when we look at today's chart. That's going to be happening in a few hours from now. And also we have Jupiter squaring Pluto. That's going to be exact by tomorrow. That's a pretty powerful aspect, actually. We also have the Sun sextile Neptune. That's exact by May 18. Mercury coming off that retrograde is starting to build up momentum forward again. It's in its retrograde shadow, so it has to go through territory it's already been going back and forth with for weeks. But it is starting to move forward, and it is going to be sextile Saturn. So that's a useful aspect as well by May 18. And then also we have the moon conjunct the sun. That's the Taurus new moon coming up exact by May 19. We also have Mars changing signs. That's pretty big right there. Mars ingressing Leo on May 20th. And then that night, Mars opposes Pluto. So that's a pretty powerful day right there by the end of the week. And then we have the sun ingressing Gemini. This is a change of focus, a change of season, and a change where the transits are happening in your chart as well. We're talking about that. We also have the sun trine. The sun is trine Pluto right as it comes into Gemini. So that's another indication of a lot of transformation in the air this week. And then the sun is also sextile Mars. And then by next Monday, Mars is square Jupiter. Oh, also the Sun is sextile Mars, if I missed that one. So yeah, there's a lot going on here. And like I said, it's all written out in the description so that you know the exact timing for all these transits. So looking at the chart here, let's just get right into the daily chart for Tuesday, May 16. The moon is waning through the rest of Aries, and it's about to enter the dark moon phase where it's behind the sun until it reaches that new moon, and then it'll start waxing. But it's going to be waning through the rest of Aries, waning through all of Taurus, and closing out this last eclipse cycle before we get to this new cycle that's rooted at the end of Taurus before there is this big change with the sun coming into Gemini, and the moon will be waxing through Gemini and ingressing Cancer by the end of this week. So today, actually, there's only one thing happening. Technically, the moon is with Chiron, and that brings up a lot of these things that people are going through with Chiron, where we have insecurities, where we have wounds, things that are deeper, how we feel about our individuality, our freedom, our independence. This Aries vibe is closing out. This is the last day of all this Aries that we've been experiencing all year with Jupiter and Aries. So it's a pretty significant day. You know, and as I said last week, Jupiter is at the last degree, the eclipse degree of 29 Aries. You know, so we've been seeing in general, if that was aligned with your chart, there's a lot of changes that people are experiencing that's continuing from that eclipse. And it's a closing out of the Aries vibe and coming into all this Taurus. There's actually going to be a pretty big stellium in Taurus this week before we get to the Gemini season. Yeah, I think with the moon here closing things out, it's bringing up some sensitivities, some things that we have to look at about our freedom, our independence, our individuality, and how to integrate changes for the future when it comes to what we want and where we're headed. But the only major aspect is Jupiter ingressing Taurus. And that's going to be, like I said, in a few hours from the time I'm making this report. And what we see is that, yeah, Jupiter leaves Aries and it just leaves Chiron and the moon there for the rest of the day. So Chiron's going to be there for a few more years, but that's kind of an undercurrent. It's not like, you know, a major planet or anything. So the vibes are waning here. There's a sense of having to let go, a sense of changes on the horizon this week as the moon goes through here. And with Jupiter now in Taurus, this is a pretty big change in your birth chart. Wherever you have Taurus in your birth chart, there's this new transit for the next year, basically, with Jupiter here. And it's going to be, Jupiter's going to be moving all the way to about mid-Taurus this year. It'll go retrograde, so it's going to be going back and forth. But the first half of Taurus is really going to see this new vibe of Jupiter that's wanting to expand. But there's going to be issues with this as Jupiter comes into Taurus and squares Pluto. I'll talk about that for tomorrow. But it's not going to be necessarily quick or easy with these big changes. It's going to create a lot of intensity. But still, there's changes. And you're going to start to see that and definitely feel it with Jupiter here. So Jupiter is considered a positive transit. However, Jupiter tends to expand whatever it's touching in your chart. So if you have planets around the first few degrees of the fixed signs of Taurus and Leo, Scorpio, and Aquarius, then Jupiter will be squaring or opposing those planets or conjunct. And that's going to increase, you know, anything going on in your life that those aspects are talking about in your birth chart. So if you were born with a fixed square in the beginning of the degrees, Jupiter will amplify that intensity that you were born with for good or bad. But it's because there wants to be changes happening, and sometimes squares are forcing us to have changes. You know, there's too much tension just to let it be. Life is pushing us into something here, and that can create a lot of restlessness and stress and change for most people if it aligns with your chart. But in general, you still have the sign Taurus in your birth chart somewhere that represents a certain area of your life. In general, it's talking about money and resources, our values, you know, materialistic things that are more grounded and practical and heavy. Now we have a lot of Taurus going on here, especially when the moon comes into the dark moon phase in Taurus and starts to close out that last cycle that we're currently in right now. That's going to be a huge stellium of Taurus vibes, which is all about practicality. So it wants to be about the future because the North Node is here. And eventually Jupiter is going to activate that North Node as well. Talking about Uranus here, you know, the sun has been focused on Uranus this last week of creating innovation and changes for the future when it comes to materialistic things. So Jupiter here is going to start to expand all these ideas, all these possibilities, opportunities for growth and change within a very practical way within your life or the area of your life that Taurus is in your chart. So you have to kind of know your birth chart a little bit to get an idea of that. We can't just say the rising sign and then say the house, because there's still different houses within your chart depending on the house system. And so you kind of really need to know your chart a little more. And most of you do, I think, that listen to my reports. So in general, though, it is talking about new changes within the financial system. And I think some of this intensity coming up is going to be about the economy, financial changes, banking situations, the world, what's happening overall in the world. And then, again, it's trying to look at the future and create changes for the better. But these changes aren't necessarily instant. So it's only the very beginning of an increase to value in new ways and worth and the future around money and resources and what you need and want. It's also going to increase the need for a lot more practical situations in your life, you know, wherever you have Taurus. So Taurus has a lot to say about food and gardens and growing different types of things, changes in how we produce food, and just overall how we live with the world, the earth itself. There's going to be this increase and this need for new situations within those types of contexts. So that's a huge change that we're experiencing today. So get ready. If you have fixed planets around the beginning, you're going to really feel this change coming up. And that's the only aspect for Tuesday. So let's get to the following day here on Wednesday, May 17. And we see that the moon right off the bat, really early in the morning, is closing out that Aries vibe, that last cycle, and ingressing Taurus. And here we have this huge Taurus stellium going on where there's just so much heaviness. You know, it is kind of slow energy. Overall, I think things are going to start picking up, becoming faster compared to the last month. but it's still a Taurus. It's dense, it's heavy, it's practical. It doesn't like to change, even though there's no way around it because of the North Node here, Jupiter here, Uranus here. Change is coming. And plus, like I said before, Mercury is starting to build up momentum forward. So it's still sluggish, it's still heavy, but it's really, it can be kind of stubborn too. But it's about, you know, closing out the past in a lot of ways and preparing for the future, preparing for something new that's coming up. Right as the moon comes into Taurus, it's with Jupiter. So this is a new vibe that emotions are connected to. It's a pretty big emotional change. It's a pretty big circumstance change for the most part. Because again, Jupiter hasn't been here in 12 years. And the moon hasn't been with Jupiter in this position in 12 years. So the moon is considered exalted here. It is a placement that is about comfort and safety and food and pleasure, keeping things beautiful and calm and peaceful. The moon coming in here will kind of slow the vibe for the next few days until we get into the Gemini season a little more, because the moon in Aries is definitely more impulsive and quick and out there, independent. Now things kind of slow down, and but they're still big. There's big emotions, there's big needs. In fact, with the moon and Jupiter and Taurus, it's like there's a really big appetite for things that we want and things that we desire. But at the same time, right as the moon comes in here, it squares Mars. Actually, it was square Mars right before it left Aries, I'm sorry. But it still has this vibe of tension because Mars is coming to the last degrees of Cancer. So it's talking about, you know, looking at the chart, there's a lot of Taurus, which is about money and resources and practicality. And then there's the Cancer vibe, and Venus rules all this Taurus. So it comes back down to home and family and immigration issues, safety, security, and comfort and needs, and basically home and family life and money life, strong emotional needs for things that people are picking up on. So the mood is big, but it's still kind of heavy and sluggish at the same time and intense because the moon is also square Pluto. So it's like there's just this big transformation that starts to happen, I think, by the middle of the week, and a big mood change. There can be even a sense of something being forced upon us that's changing. We don't really have a choice but to change here. And so because it's fixed energy of Taurus, it can feel a little stubborn if you're resistant to change. So try not to hold on too tight. You know, the moon is in the dark moon phase here. It is waning. It is about letting go on some level as well, preparing for the future. So if you feel like your life is changing or something is coming up that's forcing you to change, kind of don't fight against it. Kind of go with the flow the best you can because it's supposed to be this way. And it really does come back to a lot of emotional needs and feelings because of Venus ruling all this within Cancer. But there could still be power issues, literal power issues, struggles, undercurrents that people are picking up on. Taurus is all about the surface stuff and the practical stuff. But because it's picking up on Pluto square, there's undercurrents of intensity at the same time that people are dealing with. And then the moon is with the nodes of fate. So the moon is conjunct the North Node of Destiny on Wednesday. It feels like a pretty powerful day midweek here on Wednesday. The future, everything happening, the circumstances, you know, whatever's going on in your life by Wednesday, it has a connection to what's developing for the long-term future with the moon, Jupiter, and the North Node, and Mercury as well. You know, with Mercury changing direction, starting to move forward, there's some new clarity. There's things that have been on the mind for weeks already that we're starting to understand a little better, starting to see things differently. And you know, I think it has a strong connection to home and family and living situation, needs, safety, security, and comfort, and money in the future, your values, what's important for you. You know, so everything is aligned for the long-term future and what's playing out here. You might not see all the instant results here on Wednesday, but there's still like ripple effects and connections to what's developing for your future by midweek. And then the moon is conjunct Mercury as well. So it is like really aligning the heart and the mind together. And there could be new realizations, new understandings that we've been kind of going back and forth with. There could be this strong emotional need to communicate, to travel, to get out and about. It is still kind of behind the scenes, you know, like a retreat. It's inward because it is a dark moon. So it's not like totally out there and totally visible. It could just be our own mental processing and understanding our needs, what we want, where we're going. And overall, starting to see things change slowly in the world as well. And just the overall vibe and circumstances beginning to change. And then we do get this moon sextile Saturn right before Jupiter makes the exact square to Pluto. I mean, even though it's not exact until the last aspect of the day with Jupiter, Pluto, it's still, even right now, it's activated. It's already super tight. So there's already a lot of intensity. And what this shows is that with the moon sextile Saturn, you know, it's like we can be mature about it. We can be practical and logical and down to earth about these desires, these needs, our values that are changing, and just overall where we're going, what we want, and how to structure and build that for the future. Again, with Mercury Moon, it's also mental and our heart on the same page, starting to understand something differently. But because of Jupiter square Pluto, which is exact tomorrow, I mean, that's a pretty powerful aspect of wanting change so badly that there might be some people trying to force the situation, you know, creating a lot of tension. But the problem is we can only go so fast. This is sluggish, slow energy on one level, and you can't just have everything instant. So there can be a lot of frustration. There can be a lot of resourcefulness and determination to make something happen. Like the change, the feeling of needing something to change in your life is just overwhelmingly strong. And that's going to be definitely the case if you have planets around those beginning degrees of the fixed signs. If you don't have any planets around these areas of the sky, then, you know, it's just the background vibes. You may not be as affected by it as much. But overall, it's a powerful need for change. And you have to be careful of forcing things and things not turning out just right, you know. Or it can feel like you want something so badly and yet it's not working out exactly the way you want it. There's something that has a power over you, or there's someone else in control of this dynamic or the situation that's making it more difficult for you. So that's why I say you have to have patience and you have to be wise and mature. There could also be, you know, issues around education, belief systems going through transformations. You know, what you thought was true for a while could now no longer be the way you're thinking about something or believing in something. You know, beliefs and opinions and philosophies about things are going to be going through a forced change, a forced transformation based on this alignment. And it's picking up on a lot of money and resource dynamics connected to groups and community and science and social vibes, politics. So there's like definitely some sort of a financial dynamic here, most likely. Again, this could be talking about banks, the economy, some sort of a forced economic change that's happening from government, you know, or other forms of financial dynamics and any kind of social situation that's kind of intense. And, you know, there's possibly something coming up here by mid to late week, you know, with the economy in some places around the world. But yeah, I think that's probably a strong possibility. But then it could also be talking about money, financial dynamics connected to the homeland, property, immigration issues, because it comes back to Venus and Cancer. So just expect strong, intense things happening in the world and big power struggles, legal issues, and other huge transformations that are trying to take place that's a little bit intense and not smooth in the process. And at the same time, the moon is applying towards Uranus to close out this Uranus phase that we've been into of being a little more rebellious, wanting to liberate, have some new things, new desires, manifest new things in our lives. But the moon and sun are still wrapped around that Uranus for a while. So there's a lot going on here, a lot of powerful aspects on Wednesday, that's for sure. Then the following day, on May 18th, Thursday, that's when the moon is conjunct Uranus. There could still be some disruptions, or it could be internal because the moon is behind the sun in the dark phase. It may not be as visible, but things are definitely stirring up within and behind the scenes. There's a lot of big changes happening, whether we're seeing it in the world or not. Things are in development that we will see at some point come out. And this Jupiter square Pluto. It's not just a one-day aspect. This is going to be all week long. Like I said, it's already in play. So expect a lot of major intensity and power struggles and overall a lot of inward emotional dynamics that are being stirred up for the first few days of this week. So some disruptions, like I say, are possible. But emotionally, people are hungry for something new with Uranus. And still this emotional need to liberate and break free and perhaps let go of something on some level from the past as the moon is closing out this last cycle. But the sun on May 18th is sextile Neptune. So, and that's going to be a part of the new moon as well. So it's also like there's this focus, there's the spotlight and connection to things that are behind the scenes, dreams and fantasies and inspiration and looking, you know, feeling inspired about what you want, what you need to create on a practical, materialistic level. And usually it's about money and resources on some level and personal desires in a practical way. But it's also the ability to kind of escape as well. This is continuing to be a dark moon by May 18th. So there's a need to go within, behind the scenes, retreat, tap into your own world, fantasize, dream, have hopes, you know, so something connected to something more private. Or, you know, for other people, it's connecting to spirituality, astrology, metaphysics, music, you know, anything that takes you away from some of the more heavy, dense vibes of all this Taurus going on here. And perhaps wanting to do something a little different, you know, with the moon and Uranus. Circumstances could be showing that something is different for you by Thursday morning. That's a little out of the norm in some way, potentially. So, moon is also sextile Venus on really early Thursday morning, so that gives another connection to something of pleasure or something more private behind the scenes or connected to family, home, property. And just feeling like there's an opportunity to feel a little more satisfied with something perhaps, because the last couple days the moon has been square Venus. It's like the mood, the needs, and the desires are kind of clashing and not getting everything we want or feeling all the best of everything. But there's a better potential, especially in a private way, I think, more home way or retreat way or some kind of in your own world way of feeling content and getting something that's a little more pleasurable on Thursday morning into the afternoon. And then that's, the moon Uranus, and then also Mercury is sextile Saturn again. So the mind is pretty, you know, grounded and logical about this materialistic stuff that we've been processing and going back and forth with. You know, we have also an intuitive connection and how to build, how to structure, how to look at things in a mature way. And I think that's helpful to keep things stabilized. And overall, Taurus is pretty stable despite Uranus being there in the North Node. There could still be, you know, some big changes or big mood changes and stuff, but overall it still should be somewhat stable, pleasurable energy with Taurus leading back to Venus, because Venus doesn't have any hard aspects. Eventually Venus will square Chiron. That will be a little bit of an issue later, but for now all this Taurus is really ruled by Venus. So if Venus is doing good, then for the most part I think all this Taurus is pretty stable, despite financial changes behind the scenes that are being worked up and will show later on if they're not already. All right, so that is Thursday, and then we get to May 19, and we have this new moon for Friday, May 19. With the moon conjunct the sun at the last degrees of Taurus, we start this brand new Taurus cycle. So if you have any planets around the last few degrees of the fixed signs, you're definitely connected to this new moon, which is a new beginning. Now, it is at the end of a sign, so there's still a little bit of like an ending that comes with the new beginning. We're kind of in that vibe already from the last eclipse. So some things are still having to be let go of, but it's still a new cycle, a new beginning, a new mood, and it will turn into a pretty big change of focus and season as the sun changes signs. But it comes back. Venus is ruling this new moon. And as I said, Venus is in Cancer. And it has a wide orb square to Aries. It's like this continued part about ourselves, you know, that's going through some issues for the most part in general. Chiron in Aries, it's still talking about having to let go of some of our old ways, some of our freedom and independence and our individuality to get something better for the future. You have to be more mature. And with Mercury sextile Saturn, it offers us to be more thinking more maturely about that kind of stuff and not just so, you know, just whatever we want and being youthful and childish, selfish. It's like, think about family. Think about other people. Think about the long term and what you want to create, what you need to sacrifice a little bit to get something for the future as well, and what you need to do now to get something later as well. It's not just instant gratification with this. So it gives a more mature vibe. But because Venus, for the most part, is doing pretty good over here, doesn't have a lot of hard aspects, then I think that this new moon overall is pretty good, especially because the new moon is also trine Pluto. So it starts to open up change in an easier way for people in general. Not as forced, not as intense. Jupiter starts to slowly separate from Pluto. It's still in the background, you know, of wanting something so badly, wanting your life to change, needing something to change so badly. But as the days go on from this new moon, I think it's going to smooth out somewhat and the changes will just kind of flow in a better way. Still those background power issues, perhaps, and intensity. But for the most part, I think it's a pretty good new moon, talking about a new cycle for materialism and value and money and resources and how you're going to do that for the long-term future and what you're going to be creating throughout as we go into late spring and summer and beyond. And it's opposite if you're in the southern hemisphere, of course. So the new moon is also sextile Mars, and Mars is at the last degree of Cancer. So there's still a sense of urgency about this new moon and starting something new, and really a lot of new changes overall for people in general start to show up. But it still has this connection to the home and the family and immigration and property, real estate, needs and desires, safety, security, and comfort, and what changes we need to make to get a better life, to feel better, to have our needs met, and have more comfort and safety and all this type of stuff when it comes back to home and family and living situation and borders and the homeland itself. So a lot of immigration issues, I think, are still connected to these big changes, and then some sort of a financial dynamic connected to these big changes as well. And then the moon. Well, so that's pretty much the new moon. You know, I think overall, it also has the sextile Neptune. So it has this connection to dreams and imagination and fantasy and hopes and being inspired, you know, by behind the scenes things. And having that sextile also shows that this next cycle, this next lunar cycle, gives us an opportunity to escape into something of pleasure in our own world in some way, you know, behind the scenes as well. But it also has that connection to Mars in the home for more practical concerns as well. And then the need to like create and use your imagination and your hopes and also perhaps spirituality and metaphysics for people in the astrology world as well. They can easily tap into something in the collective and something bigger and beyond as well. And remember, belief systems are changing. The way you believe about yourself, about life, where you're headed, what you can have and can't have. These things are going through a major transformation as Jupiter ingresses a new sign square Pluto. So overall, it's a pretty decent new moon. You know, I think it's going to be a lot less intense as time goes on compared to the eclipse cycle that we're coming out of. And it's going to be more stabilizing now because the moon and sun are past Uranus, that phase that was, you know, creating a little bit of rebelliousness and disruptions and the need to break free and liberate, do crazy things. Well, now it's kind of more like the usual Taurus stabilizing, and it'll have more of a stabilizing effect for the next month or so. And then the moon passes the sun and ingresses Gemini, so it begins to bring up this new vibe that we're all going to be coming into. Moon coming into Gemini starts to wax through here and trine Pluto. The circumstances, the mood start to go through a pretty big transformation in a smoother way. It's air energy, so it also is more social, communicative, the need for information, either to gain information or disseminate information, to look at the future. It's a more lighter vibe coming out of Taurus, but we still have all these planets in Taurus, so there's, you know, still pretty heavy and dense vibes, but the moon starts to bring in this more airy side of things, more intellectual, objective, communicative, and intellectual overall, with social group and community and networking, and also creates need for some people for traveling and learning, education, and just really starting to do a variety of different things at this point and not just so stuck in one kind of area of your life or just kind of more stubborn. We start to get a little more light and out there with a variety of different things and moods. The moon does make an in conjunction to the south node, still picking up on this Scorpio vibe, talking about the taboos, the hidden things, the deeper side, emotions that we're trying to control, investment issues are coming up still, issues of loss and death on some levels, depending on your chart and how life is treating you in this phase. But there's definitely like having to make adjustments between those deeper, more intense sides of life versus this more light, airy, communicative, intellectual side. And then the moon is square Saturn. You know, as I said before, with this new transit of Saturn in Pisces, all the mutable signs have to adjust. You know, every time there's a transit in the mutable signs, we're picking up on a square to Saturn or an opposition to Saturn. So with the moon in Gemini square Saturn by Friday, after the new moon by later on Friday, the last aspect of the day, you know, there's still behind the scenes things that aren't allowing us to be completely free or completely lighthearted. There's still serious vibes in the air, serious situations and circumstances, a little bit of a sobering mood. But it's the beginning of trying to move past something with this Saturn, because then the sun is going to come in and the sun will have to square Saturn. So once the sun gets past Saturn, you know, we're going to be kind of getting more and more lighter compared to all the heavy, intense things going on for most people. But we also, you know, it's the first quarter between the moon and Saturn of responsibilities and commitments and feeling the pressures and what we want and what we have to do and thinking about these things as the moon is in Gemini. And that's ruled by Mercury. You know, as the moon is going through Gemini, it comes back to this Mercury that's still in a position that we've been dealing with for weeks. So it's still bringing up things of the past that we're still needing to do, that we've been thinking about. And this is where we feel the pressure too of, you know, to create, to build, to take care of business, to do something that we need to do, that there's a feeling of heaviness in the background with Saturn about it, responsibility and commitments. All right, so that's the last aspect for Friday until we get to Saturday, May 20th. And this is a big day where there's only two aspects, but they're pretty intense with Mars changing signs. Mars ingresses Leo, and then Mars opposes Pluto. So even though the moon is in Gemini, it's not the most light that we've ever experienced, that's for sure. We still have so much heavy energy from Taurus. And then Mars changing signs, it's a big change of power, a big change of drive and passion now. Mars coming into Leo is way more passionate than Mars in Cancer, you know. And there's also a change with the immigration issue, with laws, and just our overall, what's driving us, you know. Again, now there's a big, it's kind of a grand cross if you include the Scorpio South Node, but you still have this Jupiter and Taurus squaring Pluto that's going on all week long. That's creating this massive change, or this massive need for change. And then Mars comes along, the action planet, the desire planet to make things happen. So it makes that need even stronger. You know, this pretty powerful aspect of transformation and change and intensity and people pushing hard for something. It's a little more dramatic and out there, outgoing, and extreme. There's a lot of extreme vibes happening. And then the sun is approaching the last degree of Taurus as well. things wanting to end and change and move forward. But you have to be careful of how much you're pushing, how much you're forcing the issue. It's a fine line. You don't want to just like be passive and let things pass you by. But at the same time, you don't want to like create crisis or force something that's just not flowing well. You have to have a lot of patience with this aspect all week long. You know, you're going to see a lot of changes in your life. I guarantee it coming up for the rest of May and into June and beyond. But not everything can happen instantly and quickly that, for the most part, people want something to happen here. And this is also going to change the overall vibe with war, conquest, any kind of, you know, military campaigns, basically, or your plans, what people are doing. There's a change here in a major way. It's much more outward and dramatic and passionate and bold and expressive. It's much more kind of a more like, let's go get it. Let's make it happen. But then Mars is square Jupiter as well, and it's a little bit too much. You know, so that's why I say kind of you got to be mature and smart about what you do. Don't be too overly impulsive or overextend yourself or force the issue when it's not smooth or it's not ready to happen just yet. So the Mars opposite Pluto all day after that big energy change with Mars and Leo, it could create opposition. Oppositions usually play out through relationships, you know, one-on-one connections. Being opposed, someone of power opposing your will, opposing your drive, opposing what your heart is calling for. Because now with Leo being activated, it's much more heartfelt and passionate with what you want and need. And it comes back to the sun, though. So at first, you know, I think it's going to be a pretty big change, because at first the sun is at the last degree of Taurus, still kind of stubborn and fixed a little bit. Life itself could be blocking people, that feeling of intensity with power issues and control. But as the day goes on, then we're going to see the sun change signs. But that's going to be the following day. Let me back that up. Let me look at the 20th. Yeah, the 20th just has those two aspects. So by the time we get to Sunday, May 21st, the sun enters Gemini. And that's a huge change of focus, a change of season for all of us. Now your house of Gemini has both the moon and the sun in transit through it in this waxing way, and the sun picks up on that trine to Pluto. So by Sunday, you know, something has changed that this Mars opposite Pluto was talking about. It's intense, it's a little bit of a struggle at first, but it leads to a change of focus because the sun is ruling Leo. And now wherever you have Gemini in your birth chart, that's where the new focus is, the new season for the next month. And it's bringing in new situations now. So overall, it's about travel, learning, education, communications is a major new vibe. Now this is air energy. It's intellectual. It's social. It's about networking, communicating ideas and thoughts. But it still comes back to Taurus because Mercury is ruling it. So it still comes back to things we've been thinking about and going back and forth with for weeks already. But now we can start moving forward in new ways with new ideas and new thoughts about it, new understanding about it. And overall, a smoother transformation starts to take place. Our focus starts to change here in a smoother way, but yet it's still connected to powerful situations with groups, communities, friends, social energy overall, causes, science, politics. A lot of big changes that we're going to see by this weekend into next week with all this. And the sun is also sextile Mars, so it gives this better focus to do something, to be driven, to take appropriate action. But it still has some sort of a power opposition going on at the same time. So there's still other people that could still be standing in the way. There could still be frustrations, intensity, and just this need to be taking action on something regardless. But still have to be patient. Not everything is instant still with all this. And overall, we're talking about a pretty big transformation in the air for the mood, the focus, the world, and if it aligns with your chart, for you as well. And the moon has to make a square to Neptune from Gemini. So this is where it's pretty later on Sunday, when it does that. So the moon at the last degrees of Gemini waxing forward, it has to get past this Neptune. You know, that could be big storms, big earth events happening as well by this weekend, potentially. Water events of some kind, but usually it's about storms on a practical level. And then also like information and communications and the mood. Could be some confusion going on here. We have to get past some blind spots. We have to get past an energy level of some kind that could be holding us back, a draining vibe of some kind. But it's also about storytelling with Gemini and Neptune square, you know, creating stories. Are they true? Are they not true? Belief systems are still going through major transformations as well. But just kind of like hold back on, you know, everything that you're saying or thinking about on late Sunday afternoon, basically. Don't believe everything you hear right off the bat. Take time to process your feelings, your needs, how you're thinking about things, what you're hearing. It's a little bit chaotic. Could be a need to retreat as well a little bit here with this big change of vibe, doing something new, doing something different. But the moon still has to get past a little bit of something that's a little bit of a blind spot of some kind, or an illusion, you know, disillusionment, disappointment a little bit on some level for some people, on potentially. And then the moon ingresses Cancer, so that's a pretty big mood change. And the moon loves to be in Cancer. And finally, the moon can start to appreciate Cancer a lot more because Pluto's not there. Now, Pluto will ingress Capricorn again, you know, for the last few degrees, so it's not totally done, but this time the moon and Venus are going to be a lot happier with Pluto not in Capricorn. So now it comes back to home and family vibes and the need to be inward. Even though the moon's waxing, it's still talking about home, family, emotions, sensitivity. And with Venus there, the moon is approaching Venus. So there's a sweet tooth, a sweet vibe, a need for pleasure, a need for relationship and love, family, something just more pleasurable that's inward. Safety, security, and comfort, you know, becomes a strong emotional need. And the moon is also sextile Jupiter right off the bat as it comes into Cancer. It does have to make that quick in conjunction to Pluto. So adapting, adjusting to all these outward worldly things, power struggles that we were going through, you know, leading up to all this, the intensity, the social dynamics. Now the moon is like adjusting and wanting to be more inward and talking about things that are more pleasurable. But then the moon is sextile Jupiter, and it's talking about money and resources and pleasure and your overall values in context to home, family, and relationships and needs and safety and security and comfort. Basically bringing up what you want, what you need to feel good. So overall, I think it's a better vibe coming in here. And then the sun, like I said, is sextile Mars. There's still a possibility for action and passion and creativity, you know, but it kind of comes back to the home for a few days as the moon is waxing through there. So then we get to the following day on Monday, May 22nd, and the moon is connected to the nodes of fate in an easy, smooth way. So anything that's been taking place through the weekend, we start by Monday, it's connected to our future. You know, money, investments, resources, and has a long-term effect, whatever's taking place. Also, the moon is trine Saturn, and so it's a grand trine. You know, it can help stabilize emotions and feelings and needs. And it is watery energy. There is more feelings involved in this phase. That's where the pleasure is. Both Moon and Venus are in Cancer, the home and the family, the inward energy, the safety and what in your own shell of what you enjoy. And then with all the Taurus still taking place, it's still pretty earthly and grounded, practical. Saturn helps keeping things stabilized here from behind the scenes. And then the Moon is sextile Mercury, so it's also great to communicate. Heart and mind are on the same page. Get your point across. Understand yourself. Other people can understand you better. Network from the home. Communicate. Learn. Teach. Sun in Gemini could still, you know, sextile Mars could still, for some people, have this need to travel, explore, sightsee, get out and about, do a variety of different things, even though the mood is still a little more inward for this little phase here. And then the last aspect is Mars square Jupiter, which is exact, but it was kind of in play the entire time, all week until we get to next week. Mars square Jupiter, a lot of activity, you know, is possible. Like I said, going overboard, doing too much, forcing the issue. There could also be some debates and conflicts with belief systems, with legal issues, trying to get your point across, really fighting for, you know, truth or what's right or what's wrong. You know, a lot of powerful, intense communications is possible with the Sun in Gemini, Mars opposite Pluto, T-square, Jupiter like this, trying to force things, trying to make things happen. It's still in the background overall. It's good that the moon here is in Cancer, though, at the time, trine Saturn. So I think that helps keep things somewhat stable. But there could be some big Earth events potentially this week into next week as well, or other big events happening in the world. There could be like protests, you know, people, like I say, fighting for truth and beliefs or politics or just, you know, other forms of groups and people really having a lot of power over something and making things happen and trying to force changes. That could be possible for sure. Or the Earth itself, you know, going through changes and transformation. All right, folks, so that's what I have for you. I hope that's helpful, and I wish you all the best. Take good care.